Hi viewers, welcome to Techie Track YouTube channel. Today we are going to discuss about ReactJS interview questions. So the questions will be the real time questions, like scenario based questions. It's not like normal questions like what is ReactJS, what is JSX, what is the difference between ReactJS and AngularJS. I'm not going to post that kind of questions, because if the person is getting started to learn ReactJS, they will come to know about the answers for those questions. Okay, so here the questions I come up with, like what are all the questions I faced. Also, as an interviewer, I am asking these kind of questions to the persons who are attending the interviews. Okay, before we start our questions, actually due to some network issues, I am not able to post the videos frequently for the past 2 to 3 weeks, so I am apologize for that. Please continuously watch our channel's videos and subscribe it. Okay, so the first question is, so for each click, right? So if you are watching our channel continuously, you may know about it, right? We already developed this kind of application called Vadakara, and we developed these things. So here we have the plus and minus buttons to increase and decrease our quantities. So this is the basic shopping cart website, right? If you click add button or if you click the minus button, the overall items will be getting displayed in the top of the page, right? If you see that in the right side of the screen, within that shopping cart icon, we are displaying the number of items what we purchased. So if we click the plus button, then the appropriate items count also needs to be increased, and the shopping cart icon, right, the inside that shopping cart icon, that total count also needs to be updated properly. So how you will do these updates? Okay, so this kind of question I'm asking actually. So if you have a simple shopping cart website, and I need to show the total count, total number of items, I want to display the total number of items dynamically, how can I do that? How can I update the external components value also? This is the first question. So you can find the relevant code in our channel. Also, you can try with it yourself, because I am not posting the answers for this question, because it would be very helpful if you are developing yourself and you can get more knowledge about it. Okay, so move on to the next question. So generally, if a simple website, right, we need to store the values, right? For example, once you log into the application, you need to keep some basic information inside the website, right? In the client side, you need to store the username, users, countries, code, or basic details, what are all the details need for your application. So in ReactJS, where you will store this basic information? Generally, we are storing this client information in the client cookies, or somebody is store the values in the local storage. But store the information in the local storage is not the advisable one. We have some other ways. So we most probably people are referring the cookies, either in JavaScript cookies or Redux cookies, whatever it is, they are storing the information. So this is the question I am asking. How can you persist the values in your local environment? How you will store the basic information of the users? Okay, like if the user is logged into your application, you want to store the username and the first name, last name, country, those things. So how, where you will store that? How can you store that? That is another one, a scenario based question. Next one is, it is the Axios related. Okay, so generally in the any website, right, you need to pull the data from the database, then you need to develop the services, service API, you need to write it. You need to call the service API using the Axios or Fetch. So to make a call for the Axios, right, suppose the service is not responding immediately. So how can you handle that? Because if the service is not responding immediately, or if the service is throwing the exception, how you will handle that situation? How you will handle that scenario? Because Axios is having certain parameters in get and fetch. So based on that parameters, how can you handle that? That is the question I am asking actually. Next one is, how can you do the exception handling in ReactJS? Because if a user is working with your application, Suppose the application is making some problem or it is not able to render the data into the UI, it should not stop the application abruptly. Suddenly it should not stop that, and suddenly it should not display the 404 exception or some other awkward exception it should not throw. Okay, it needs to give the exception in the most readable and understandable way. Okay, so that's the thing, how you will handle that kind of scenario, how you will handle the exception in React. Okay, next one is, so you have the simple application. So the application is having two kind of users. One is normal user, another one is the user is trying to log into the application. Okay, so once the user is logged into the application, you need to display the deals, offers related to the user. Okay, suppose if the user is not signed into the application, you won't display the deals and offers for the general user. So for these two kinds of user, you need to display the application with two different kind of mode. For the logged in user, it is displaying in a list of features. If the user is not logged into the application, you are not going to list up certain basic details only. Okay, so you may face this kind of situation in any other shopping cart websites, right? Because if you are not logged into the application, it will show the default details. Suppose if you log into the application, it will show the offers and deals for your account. Okay, because if you purchased a lot of items earlier, they will give the special offers to you, but the special offers are not getting displayed for the basic users. So in this scenario, if you want to render the application for normal user and sign in user, so how you will handle it? Okay, so you can't write a if condition for all the components, because if, for example, I have the simple component, it needs to display the offers and deals. Okay, so for the sign in user, it is displaying 5 offers. For the normal user, it is displaying the only one offer. So in this scenario, how I am doing the code, I will put on if condition. I am just checking that if the user is sign in user or not. If the user is a sign in user, then I will display 5 offers. If the user is not signed into the application, then I will display the only one offer. If the application is having only one component, then this kind of coding is fine. Suppose if the application is having n number of pages, you can't implement the same kind of if condition in all the pages. Okay, the code will be the awkward one, and that is not the advisable one to develop the application. You can deal these kind of scenarios in the webpack. Okay, I will put a separate video for how we can create the webpack, how we will accommodate for these different kind of users in the webpack. I will explain it in the later point of time. So in the next video, I will come up with more questions and more interesting topics. Thanks for watching this channel. Happy coding. Bye bye. Thank you.